Welcome to the latest edition of the SWN Podcast. This is a bit of an impromptu episode, just because I really wanted to do an episode. And I'm speaking this time on this edition with the Hellhound himself, Jason Hyde. How's
Hello.
It going?
Yeah, I'm all right. How are you?
I'm really well, thank you. Thank you for asking. We'll pretend we didn't already have this conversation off here. I want to speak to you. Mainly, I reached out to you because we're having a lot of fun right now. A time of recording with the tournaments on Twitter, which I've forgotten. Oh, the Survivor Series, which you were sadly eliminated from with Sharky Fossil. But I want to speak to you because the promos themselves were just hilarious. So I want to know a bit more about Jason Hyde. So usual boring question to start off with. How did you get into pro wrestling?
So actually, I was speaking to my mum about this recently. I don't know why she told me it, but apparently wee tiny four-year-old Jason tidied his room so he could stay up late to watch a scary film, but was too scared of said scary film, and it was like a pure Disney scary film. So my dad switched over and SmackDown was on, I think, so just since then I've just been kind of hooked on it.
So what year was that, approximately?
It would have been about 2000.
Oh, right, okay. So you're around about the same kind of age for starting, and that's fine. Is anyone you remember from that time? Anyone that caught your eye straight away?
Mostly, like, The Rock. I was properly obsessed with The Rock. Like, I think there's one of my school photos when I was really young and I'm doing the eyebrow.
Oh, yeah, I mean, are you a really wrestling fan around about 2000s if you didn't spend your time looking in the mirror trying to do the people's eyebrow?
As I got older, like maybe when I got to about 8 or so, it was moved to a Jeff Hardy obsession, which has stuck with me since. So, but at the time, it was definitely The Rock.
I knew the right person to contact, being a Jeff Hardy fan. So that's yeah, that's pretty much my memories of it. Started with Undertaker and Kane scaring me, and then the Hardy Boys, Steve Austin, The Rock, all that kind of good stuff. So, how did you go from being the fan to pursuing being a wrestler?
At the time, I just didn't have anybody to watch pay-per-views with, so I kind of forced Darryl Costello to get into wrestling. I was like, you need to like this, it's happening. And it was like a pretty innocent like. So then he took up an interest in wanting to train, but he's like a pure quiet guy. And he was like, so I said I'll go with him, and then I just kind of stuck with that. I'm still there.
So it dragged them along, and yeah. That was it from there. What was your first impressions of training?
It was a lot more real than I was expecting, to be honest. Like, I was in agony after it, but I was like a good agony. It was definitely, I was definitely instantly excited to go back to it, but it was so difficult at the start, man. Because I had to lose a good bit of weight as well. I think I was like 4 stone since I started training. So like that, mate, since then it's been a lot easier and a lot better, but that was pretty difficult at the start.
So just like the cardio bit of it then, or was it just the absolute
just bumping? That, and I just for so long could not bump well. Like for so, my elbows are just a mess because, you know, I think I'm all right now, but for so long I just could not bump well and I was just ruining my back.
So who would you, maybe a bit awkward, but who would you credit as your trainers? Would it be, was it TJ Rage?
TJ Rage and Krieger as well. He had a big part in it as well.
So speaking of Krieger, this is what brought, this is why I contacted you for the podcast, because of your shenanigans with Krieger. So was that just a friendship struck up through wrestling training, or?
We went to the same school, but I didn't know him. He was like a few years older than me. He was in my like big cousin's year, and then when I started training, he asked me if that was my cousin, and then that's just how I realised we're both as weird as each other, so it kind of stuck for there. Yeah.
Yeah, so for anyone who hasn't watched, it'll be a couple of weeks since it all happened, but it included getting a bag over your head and being instilled into the Krieger dojo.
Dojo of Excellence.
Yeah.
Still not sent me my certificate for passing the training.
Well, I mean, did you pass if you lost?
No, we'll skip my, it's like I can like a consolidation prize or whatever it is.
So your favourites, so you gravitated towards Jeff Hardy when you kind of started rock, then Jeff Hardy. And is there any favourites you have now that you kind of either try and emulate or have influence from?
Yeah. I'm like everyone now, man. I'm obsessed with Keith Lee. And as well, Kaylee Ray as well. Since I started going to like Scottish shows, I've always thought she was just amazing. So I've been a big fan of hers for a long while as well.
So when did you start going to Scottish wrestling shows? Was it?
It was about 2016, I think.
It was
a SWA show in Marlborough, I think it may have been.
It's like a battle zone or something like that, around about.
Yeah, it was something like that. Yeah, I don't remember it too well. I remember Stevie Xavier was in, I think, the opener. I can't remember who was wrestling, but I remember he was in the opener. That's like the main part of it, because I've always been a fan of his as well since I started going to the shows as well.
So it must be quite cool. I mean, round about where you trained, that's where Stevie come from. So was that kind of why you gravitated towards that area, that school specifically?
We looked into quite a lot, and it is the closest one to us as well, but that wasn't really ever a factor in choosing it. We did kind of look at who it had produced, with the likes of like Stevie and Kaylee, Kenny Williams and things like that, Noam. So there's like a lot of people that they've kind of produced that are just top class in this country, so that's where we gravitated towards when we were looking into it.
Absolutely. What was it like in your first match then? Do you remember who you were against or what your feelings were into it?
Yeah, I was ridiculously nervous. It was I was supposed to be in an 8-man, but due to travel restrictions, there was 2 8-mans on the show, and half of each match got like stuck in traffic and couldn't get to the show. So it ended up being split into 2 just normal tag matches. So the change in it really freaked me out as well, because I was sitting planning everything kind of before they got there, and we had something like about like my entrance and things like that. I had all the kind of things in my head, and then that just turned them right on the heat. So I was really panicking about that, but it went well. Everything, I didn't die.
That's the least that you hope from match, I'm guessing.
Yeah, I'm still walking.
Brilliant. So I know from my very brief research, for anyone listening, this is actually probably the first time I've done research for a podcast, because I'm trying something new, actually, trying to make these things good. You've had a few matches along the way, including Pro Wrestling Innovation, Pro Wrestling Scotland, Respect Pro Wrestling. So you're starting, obviously, right now there's no travelling about because there's no wrestling on because of COVID.
Yeah.
What was it like going into different... I mean, I know Pro Wrestling Scotland and PWI are TJ Rage's and Krieger's companies, yeah, respectively, so that would be kind of usual. What was it like going into a bit of a new company like Respect Pro Wrestling?
They were really, really welcoming. I got a message from Bobby, and he said that they had a show coming up that was like a bit further away in the future, so we took that date, and then he needed some people for a few shows prior to that, so I took those as well. And yeah, that was just like, there was a really welcoming atmosphere there. Like, everybody was very, because like that was the first few times that I was at shows that like I didn't already know everybody there, and there was like everybody was like dead talkative and easy to kind of talk to. The only person I knew was Daryl Costello, because he was living with me at the time, so that he was like the only person I knew, but it wasn't awkward or like nerves wracking at all, because I'm quite an awkward person, as you'll probably tell this whole interview. But yeah, so it was really nice as well, and like it was good to get in new areas and stuff, because I was kind of afraid at the time that my kind of whole thing was quite regionally good, like where I'm from and my weird looking like a goth but sounding like the wee man thing that's going on. Thought maybe it would only work here, but it seemed to get a quite good reception.
So is there any other companies, not just Scotland, but UK-wide that you want to get to?
So I've been looking to get down basically anywhere, to be honest. I've not had any specific ones that I've got to go, just anywhere. I kind of want to go places that I've never been. Weirdly enough, I've never actually been to London, so I'd like to go down there and do some shows.
Is there any opponents that you have your eye on that you'd want to get in the ring with? I will just say, like, reach Scotland, and then we'll kind of move further afield.
I was actually, before the world stopped working, I was booked in a match against Bradley Poole. I really, really want to get in with him. He's such a good talent. Like, honestly, he's going to set this whole thing on fire. He's amazing.
For a quick swap, won't be a spoiler because I'll put it out on Twitter before this goes out, but that's who I've got interviewed next week.
Who
I've got planned. He was supposed to be, the plan was I was going to have him like in the studio because he lives in Elgin and I live in Elgin, so it made sense, but of course the world's ending, so that might not happen, so we'll have to do it by Zoom instead. I'm assuming my connection is going to be cracking though because he's only a couple miles away, which will be grand. So yeah, so outside of wrestling, this is what I know. You like Doctor Who.
Yep.
And you like Star Wars.
I do. Also horror movies. I'm like, just anything a bit nerdy. I mean, like, except anime, I've never got into anime for some reason. But everything else, I'm just a pure nerd for.
That's fine. We've spoken about anime plenty in past podcasts, but horror movies is just, it's nae for me. I just can't handle jump scares. Just can't do them. It's just, no. So what would you say would be your top, I don't know, 3-5 horror films?
Well, I've got I can't really show it because it's wrapped right now because it's just fresh. But I've just got a tattoo of Squirtle from Pokemon dressed as Jason Voorhees.
I saw that on Twitter. Yes, I saw you put that picture of that up. Yeah, it's cool.
I did it. So Friday the 13th, Nightmare on Elm Street, and Halloween, the really generic ones are like definitely my favourites. But like, there's this film I watched about a year ago called The Terrifier, I think it is. And it's like, it's so bad, it's good. And it's, I love that kind of thing. Like, see, like The Room, it's like a horror version of The Room. That's the best way I can describe it.
Yeah, as scary as I go is Ghostbusters. That's about, it's called Ghosts. Doctor Who, so horror is something I know next to nothing about because I don't watch them at all. Doctor Who I know a little bit about, mainly because I started watching when the revamp came in 2005 or something like that. So again, what drew you to Doctor Who, and who would be your favourite Doctors?
My favourite Doctor's Peter Capaldi. Mostly as well because I like to think of him playing Malcolm Tucker as the Doctor and swearing at Daleks. I think that's really funny. But he's definitely my favourite. But I think I just get into Doctor Who by finding my dad's VHSs. He had like, because my dad's like a big fan of it as well. So like, I found a bunch of them and just watched a bunch of VHS of it, and then I was totally hooked on it. I'm getting a display case in the office in my house that's going to have like sonic screwdrivers all like placed in it and stuff.
It could have went so much wrong, so much worse if you went and thought, oh, some tapes under my dad's bed here. At least it was Doctor Who. could have been a lot worse. And Star Wars, again, I've seen the first trilogy, the second trilogy, and The Force Awakens. So again, it was just because it was nerdy sci-fi, is that your kind of...
Same, my dad. Most of the things I'm into is just my dad was into them, and he kind of got me in them. I'm kind of exactly the same with my nephew. Like, my nephew's got an inflatable wrestling ring in his room. So, like, we're just kind of forcing that on him. And the Star Wars, but he's not so into Doctor Who.
So, is that how you've been spending your time during lockdown then? Doctor Who and binging. Star Wars binging. Yeah.
I've actually been watching a lot more wrestling as well than I usually would. Because I don't usually find that much time to do it. And when I do it, it's like, I always want to catch up on the things I've been missing on stuff. Or like, we've been doing a podcast recently and I've been editing that. And it's been hellish because they can't stop swearing.
This is why I do the little notice before I hit record. Don't swear. I don't want to edit. So that's fine. So what's your podcast about then?
So we're doing, it's like a bit of a game show. So it's like kind of just debating about things, opinions in wrestling, and being generally weird in the process. So it's kind of like we're going to do some rotating people, but it's just going to be me, Krieger, Dean Ford, and Matt Tyson. So we've made three attempts at recording it, and I'm just editing it has been hellish.
That actually sounds amazing. So once it eventually goes out, then I'm all in for featuring it on the site, because that sounds just for the 4 years bantering back and forth. In my mind, I can already tell that it's going to be weird, but
it's a lot of just Krieger putting over the fact that he's on the network. That's pretty much every 2 minutes you need to remember it. Matt's reminding us that he's a dad, and we're all reminding Dean that he's bald. But in a nice way, don't worry, it's in a nice way.
I'm sure Dean's sitting there with his belt. So the my favourite picture on Twitter is the one that ADM always puts out.
Yeah.
Dean Ford puts out an opinion, and it's just him going with belts behind him. I've actually saved it myself now, because it's gotten to the point where I see things and go, yeah, that's going out there as well. WWE Network. Obviously, yeah. Krieger's got a bit more of a more actual. He's actually wrestling on it, whereas yeah. I'm just in the background in Thunderdome at the moment. I'm fairly certain I've ruined a spot with Rollins and Murphy when they were supposed to be like doing all the tension thing, and there you see me just over Rollins' shoulders going like that. And for people that are watching the podcast, listen to it, I'm just doing the ooh fingers, and I kept going back to the YouTube thinking, oh, that's the bit they'll show, that's the big moment, and then it keeps cutting away from it. Ruined it.
Want like a gif of you just going ooh fingers.
I'm gonna find it on the network, and I'm gonna try and record it, because it was the favorite thing. Once I spotted I was there, I was like, I am ready for the camera now. it's good fun. If anyone, I think by the time this goes out, the Thunderdome might be over, because I think they ran out there at least at Amway. But yeah, it's hilarious. It's just so much fun, and it's every match you get. I've got a guy coming over the microphone going, now what do you think of this guy? Do you want to cheer him or boo him? Put your thumbs up, clap, scream. I'm just like, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I am not screaming for anyone.
I mark out for the Thunderdome, because I've been in that arena, so every time I watch it, I'm like, I've been there.
So that's currently why my personal Twitter is WWE Networks Billy Strachan, because so for future goals, let's see how I segue this. At the moment, I said nothing's on, so we don't know what's happening when shows actually come back on. But what's your long term goals? Is it WWE? Is it AEW? Is it Japan?
I just think it's just anywhere that will happen. Really, I just want to do it as much as I possibly can for as many people as possible. So the best way to do that, I want to follow that, I suppose. But like, I also quite like the idea of doing it the kind of long way around, if you know what I mean. Like, I kind of like the idea that at least if I were ever to go anywhere, to like do everywhere else first and kind of see everything that I can.
Oh yeah, sound kind of like the journeyman kind of thing, just traveling everywhere you can. I suppose when you've got guys like Krieger and Luke King Sharp as well, must be fairly close by, that have done this already or in the midst of doing it as well. It's a good way to see people, your peers, doing it.
Yeah, no, it's definitely, and like as well, it's good for like, they're like really for like being the idiots that they are. They are really good at advice and stuff as well. So it's definitely helpful having people like that close by. And TJ Reid as well, like, he just knows so much about wrestling. Like, it's amazing. He's like an encyclopedia. And the stories he's got of meeting wrestlers are amazing. He met Bret Hart at a urinal.
I feel there's more to the story. Do they speak to him while at the urinal, or is it after the urinal? Because I feel it's weird to speak to someone.
I think what happened was that he walked by him. He'd left said urinal, and Brett was going to it. Okay. And then when they were both washing their hands, he was like, oh, I liked your book, mate. I think he tells the story better, but also he gives way less detail than is necessary.
I'll be in Brett's next book. I met TJ Rage.
Fine washing of hands.
4 out of 10.
They're lashing him for about 10 minutes waiting for me.
He kept staring at me intently. I don't know if he noticed. Just... the other thing that I think I know you're into, I could be wrong, because everyone else is on this podcast, Pokemon, is that?
Yeah, I'm into Pokemon as well.
All generations, or are you just the first few?
See, I'm just the first two, man. I remember I used to like watch it, but mostly it was like the games and stuff. But then I didn't get them for a while, and then I got one when I think I found my old DS, and I was like, I'm gonna get a Pokemon game. And then one of the Pokemon was a washing machine, and I was like, it's the exact same thought process. Like, I've never seen Fast and Furious, any of the Fast and Furious films, but I know that they go from racing in the streets to The Rock punching a missile away in the Arctic, and that seems like the exact same thing. How did they get from A to B? I can't process that.
The first one, they were stealing Panasonic DVD players, if I mind right.
Right. Oh,
so, and now they're fighting in space. So... Yes, it's a bit different. So that's fine. I'm in with your level of Pokemon generations. So great. Any favourites except the washing machine one?
Psyduck, because I can relate to that duck so much. Like that's I get so like I'm dramatic about the slightest thing. So I'm essentially just a walking Psyduck. Like obviously Squirtle as well. There's a really hot photo of me dressed up with a couple of my pals in primary school as the Squirtle Squad with paper mache Squirtle helmets on and just normal size sunglasses.
Oh, I was going to say, did you get the sunglasses or we?
We got the right ones, but it was for a normal head and not a massive paper mache Squirtle head, so they just looked really stupid and the eyes were like here and then the sunglasses were like here on the nostrils.
So, I mean, I'm not saying that I'm not going to give you ideas or anything, but you, Krieger, Matt Tyson, Dean Ford, I mean, Dean's already got the head for it. Squirtle Squad, that's the future once the shoulders have turned. Just have like to blue up Dean Ford up easy.
Faction, that's the faction that blows up wrestling, isn't it? As far as the Squirtle Squad, there's two with man buns, though, they need to keep the buns.
Yeah, we've got Retaliation, Hurt Business, Squirtle Squad.
Squirtle Squad. And then we need to dress as SoundCloud rappers for a wee modern spin on the Squirtle Squad, I feel.
Oh, yeah, the oversized, like, jackets, yeah. and the boxers up to your nipples, yeah.
Yeah. Like, if you're either dressed like that or a country dad, there's no in between with me. It's that or country dad.
Well, at the moment, my dress sense is just now, I put this nice t-shirt on, because at the moment my dress sense is the oldest t-shirt I could find in joggers, because I work in an office, but this is my office now because we're working from home. So it's great. I just get up in the morning.
I'm using my office desk, the new, but it's a chair because I just set my laptop on it. And I just sit in that and do absolutely nothing all day.
Oh yeah, I took a desk. I went to the office and went, I'm having one of those desks, and took it home and everything's set up in here.
Forget about it, you can just keep it.
I think we've got to fill in a form or something. I don't know. I don't care. By the time that all comes about, it'll probably be like 2022 and nobody will know that I took this desk. But
yeah, they'll not miss it. I've decorated the place like my office, so I've got Ainsley Harriet here on the wall.
Of course.
And here is a picture of my girlfriend with a lucha mask made of ham.
Well, my decoration is my belts, because I'm sad. And I got them out from the loft. Well, before I had all this set up, I went, I want to take one of my belts down and put it out just for fun. And my wife was like, no, because just dinner. So I went up to the loft and somehow all three came down. And they're now just in my office, because this is my office now. So it's got laundry, belts, which you can't see in this particular recording, but it's everywhere. I show them off any opportunity on SWN Live.
We're currently redecorating the office part, so we're going to have just like a pure sci-fi scene going on here. I've got a tapestry that looks like the inside of the TARDIS. I'm at that level. I don't know how I have friends.
That's fine. I think you're in the right place, because although mine's mostly Marvel stuff, I keep eyeing things up on online going, I can't put that anywhere.
I'm a DC guy. I've got I can't really show you that much, but I've got like a DC sleeve.
Oh, well, I've got a Batman tattoo, but yeah, I'm more Marvel.
I've got Flash here as well, but I did have some kind of wee Marvel elements to put in that, but there just wasn't the space, so I thought we'll keep it DC and nice and depressing.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm assuming you like both, but DC's just kind of got
but they've just got the mostly Batman. It is pretty much a Batman sleeve, which got the Batman logo here and stuff, but yeah, so it's mostly Batman, but yeah, just all DC I'm a big fan of, but it's only like bits and pieces of Marvel that I kind of like. I like, I've recently been reading Black Panther, because they put out a whole run of them for free, and I was having that. So I read them in like a night, ignoring the countless things I had today, and it was fantastic. I think it was, I don't know, it was the Agents of Wakanda run. It's so good. It's amazing.
I'm the opposite then. I'm big Marvel, like the movies. I do pick up the comics every so often, but yeah, bits and pieces of DC. So Batman. Yeah. I do, as far as movies go, I really enjoyed Shazam. I thought that was amazing.
Yeah, I thought that was good too.
And I'm really looking forward to the new Suicide Squad with James Gunn helming it. So yeah, kind of the same. But together, we make up two total fans.
We make up two whole comic fans. I like it.
So another question we usually have, we actually got one fan question, and we have our usual question, so I'll go for the fan one first. It's from SPRKIX Graphics, and they're just asking, will the Blonde Streak ever come back?
This is the most annoying thing that's happened in my life, is that I went, dyed my hair blonde, and then me and Craig had met up. I think we went to Nando's and we both realised we had both done the same hair without knowing it. So like that wasn't supposed to happen. And then I went, because I actually was going to do it. So I went and got some blonde hair dye. And then when we were filming those promos, I know we've done it again. So we'll see how bored I get, to be honest. I was thinking about maybe doing a wee half and half thing, but and just completing the SoundCloud wrapper. And then next I'll move on to the full-time country now.
Just get the grill. Maybe,
I actually had one. I was going to use it. I was going to use it in a match because I was in my hometown and there was so many of like my family there, but I was a big nasty boy that evening. I was not very kind to them. And I was like, everybody's just cheering me. I don't know what to do. So I just was going to stick a grill in and be the most pretentious person I could be. Didn't work.
No, nobody could. I was thinking, when you said it didn't work, I was thinking, nobody could cheer a guy with a grill. That's just not possible, but clearly it is. So it must be great minds then. The same hairstyles constantly.
Okay-ish minds, I think. Like, poor minds think alike as well, I'm sure.
I just imagine you both just meeting up, and one of you just going, well, one of us has got to change.
See, we've actually been mistaken for each other. There was there was once where a guy come up and gave me some feedback on one of his matches, and I was like, I'll pass that on for you. And then I felt like I was getting him it, and I was in no place to do that, so that was a pure awkward situation.
And that man was Brett the Hitman Hart. So we've got another question. The usual question is from Kevin Williams, which is, what's your favourite dinosaur?
Diplodocus, it sounds funny.
Fair enough. I've had worse reasons for picks, so that's correct. And the final thing before we do your social media and wrap up this hilarious chat is I'm bringing back the 10 count. Now, for anyone not aware, it is just 10 names. First thought comes to mind, and that's it. Easy as that.
Okay.
So, easy. Number one, Krieger.
Handsome.
Two, TJ Rage.
Frightening.
Three, Sharky Fossil.
Intense, a lot, just a lot, a lot, and one word, totally spoiled.
Four, Daryl Costello.
Chicken strips.
Alright. Five, Big Benny.
I can't think of a more positive adjective for Big Benny. I can't express enough love for that man.
Six, Davros.
Dean Ford.
Seven, Savio Vega.
Icon. I think you know what I love Savio Vega.
I scroll through your Twitter feed. That was my research.
That's actually something that there was a time I genuinely thought that Savio Vega was like what Cena became.
I was in 1997. Like Savio Vega just appeared everywhere. If it was like, oh, we don't have anyone to do this spot, get Savio. It's fine. He'll do it. Eight, Looking Sharp.
Think of is that he takes his shoes and socks off when he goes into places, and it really upsets me. Like, keep the socks on, man.
Yeah.
Grow up. Sorry, I get riled up with it.
That's actually really upset me as well. So the shoes, sure. No, that was socks.
A shoe's half gaff, a shoe's half gaff, we all know that, but a soap's half gaff, just your gaff.
Anyway, we'll try and carry on. Nine, Dean Ford.
Ball. No, ice bucket, because we all slag him because he has a bucket of ice that he sits in.
I feel like number 10 is Jar Jar Binks. I feel like I should put Matt Tyson in there somewhere, but I haven't.
Matt Tyson's another one. I just don't have enough positive adjectives to describe him other than he's a dad. That's he's a dad, in case you didn't know.
That's his gimmick.
And he's the whole reason he's in the wrestling is to buy some Barbie dolls for the young one. But Jar Jar Binks, I'm on the side that loves Jar Jar Binks. I love him. I think he's amazing and hilarious. And also, I'm the same like that with everything. But everything that is universally hated, I'm pure into.
Jar Jar Binks, I didn't get the hate. But I watched episode one, skimmed episode two, because I just got so bored with it. And he was barely in episode three. So I just didn't.
I've seen a thing, actually, where there's a fan theory that he is a Sith Lord. I don't understand it, but I wanted a full saga of that and him turning to the dark side and becoming evil and mental is exactly what I need in my life.
Jar Jar Binks versus Obi-Wan Kenobi. that can't go well. Okay, so like I said, I just want to have a quick chat with you, and I think we've covered all the bases that I want to, even Jar Jar Binks stuff and terrible Pokemon, wash machine. There's an ice cream one as well, which just...
Is the Pokemon that's a washing machine, does it not, like, evolve from a fan or a hoover or something?
I have no idea. I mean, that and Looking Sharp taking socks off are the two most upsetting things I'm going to hear today.
I know, I've probably ruined your day, perhaps your week. I hope your week improves for it, but
I'm just going to go to sleep tonight, wake up thinking, oh God, is Looking Sharp in my house? Oh my God, he's taking off his socks.
And I've ruined my day saying it. I might just go straight to bed and just try again tomorrow.
the day's over. Anyway, right, before before we go and have a cry about that, how can people find you on social media?
Everywhere, it's Jason Hyde PW, Facebook and Twitter. I don't actually, like, I have an Instagram, but it's just pictures of me putting Snapchat filters on my nephews and laughing at them. So, but that's Vampire GC, if you're into that. But yeah, that's about it. I'm not on anything else, I think.
I'm trying to think. If people find you on Tumblr, then it's not you.
I made a meme on Tumblr and it got like 750,000 notes, and I still tell people that to this day, such as fitting into this podcast.
Thank God we haven't got that.
It was like Jericho holding the list of holes, and I can't remember what the caption was, but that was my work.
Anything else? Keep you busy. Twitch. Everyone else seems to be doing Twitch. Is Twitch a thing for you?
Gonna be doing Twitch. I have intentions on doing Twitch. Just need to get the office sorted for that because we'll be decorating by now. So once I've done that, I will definitely be on Twitch. I have bought some specific games for it, and I've been playing Fire Pro Wrestling World a lot recently. But I don't know if I have the enough personality to love streaming that and being watchable at the same time. Because it's mostly just me and Craig are tagging against Barney the Dinosaur and things like that.
I keep meaning to get Fire Pro. I've got it on my list on PS4. Just like, yeah. I don't want to pay anything more than a tenner for it because I don't think I'll play it enough.
Yeah. Actually, I've just got The Last of Us 2 as well, and The Last of Us is like my favourite game. So I've not been able to play that, so I was intending on playing that later today, but I think I now need to edit another podcast.
So hopefully once this one goes out, you'll have a podcast of your own. But in the meantime, thank you for chatting to me. Last-minute chat that I contacted yesterday about, and here we are. And I think I've had a good time, so I hope you have as well.
I've enjoyed it, I have. Thank you for having me.
No bother. And hopefully
I've been creating good content for you.
Yeah, so I'm sure. Yeah,
I was going to get the Dalek to show up, but he never shows up for anything.
I know, that was the saddest thing, that the Dalek was pretty much gave you a row for losing, which I thought was unfair. But at least Krieger got you in the dojo of excellence. Anyway, right, we'll keep rambling otherwise. So I'll wrap up and then we can maybe have a wee chat afterwards as well. But yeah, thank you for joining us on the show, and this will be another SWN podcast. Hope you've enjoyed.